The French Chef is made possible by a grant from Safeway Stores.
Here is Boston lettuce, chicory, romaine, and escarole. We're making French salads, French dressings, and mayonnaise today on The French Chef. Welcome to The French Chef. I'm Julia Child. Today we're going to do all kinds of things about salads in the French manner. We're going to do French-type French dressing and mayonnaise and a lovely vegetable salad called salade niçoise. And here's the kind of lettuce that we're going to use. Here's Boston lettuce, which in Boston they call native lettuce. It has big, tender, green leaves. And here is chicory, which in France is called frisé because of its frizzy leaves there. And here is romaine, which has the same name in France. It has these long leaves, which you can just tear like that, or you can, they're a little bit large to serve whole. And here is escarole, which is of the same family as chicory, but it has these long flat leaves. It's sometimes a little bitter, so you use parts of it in a salad. And I'm going to show you today how you wash and take care of salad, because it's so easy to do, but if it's stale and wilted, it's terrible. Now here with your Boston lettuce, the French don't use iceberg lettuce, so I'm just not going to show it. You take it by the root and just take a little knife and cut around like that. And then you put all the leaves into a big basin of water because you want to be sure to get all the sand off. And you wash it just like spinach. You pump it up and down in the water. And then as you take each leaf out, just make sure that there isn't any dirt down in there. And then you drain the water out. You can use one of these French salad baskets, which I got one of these at our hardware store the other day, which can also be used as a vegetable steamer, or, which I find very convenient, just use a colander. Then you put your wet lettuce in the colander and then toss it around like that. And then when you've gotten most all of the water out, you take a big clean towel. Some people even use old pillowcases, which is a good idea too. And just put your wet lettuce in like that and spread it out, and then very gently roll the towel up. You don't want to bruise the lettuce. Some people do like that, but then you break the lettuce and that makes it wilt. And then you roll it up like that and put it in the refrigerator. And then after about an hour or two, when it's all dry, you can put it into a plastic bag and it will keep for a good day or two, just like that. You want to be sure that you have your salad dry, otherwise when you put your dressing on, the dressing won't stick, and also the dressing, it makes a watery salad dressing. I forgot to mention these endives, which come from Belgium. In Belgium, it's called witloof, and it has long leaves like this. And you only get this in the wintertime. It's a perfectly lovely, lovely salad, but it's quite expensive in this country. But it's awfully nice with little beets or with watercress. And we have here watercress, which is much more delicate than any of the other lettuces. You have to keep it in a plastic bag in the icebox or in a little jar. It has a peppery taste and is lovely mixed with salad. It has little leaves like this, and it's lovely to make soup with. I'll just eat a piece. It's so good. Now, as to salad dressing, we have here washed and dressed salad. And a French salad dressing is made out of oil and wine vinegar, salt, pepper, mustard if you like it, and green herbs in season if you like them. I always like myself a light olive oil, and I was surprised when I went to Paris and found that they didn't use olive oil. They used something called huile de hachis, which is peanut oil or some other flavorless salad oil, because their feeling is if you have a strong olive oil, it coats your palate and then you can't taste the delicacy of the classical cuisine. So the proportions of the vinegar to the oil are really what you like. A lot of the books say that you use 1 tablespoon of vinegar to 1 tablespoon, 3 tablespoons of oil. I find that too strong. In our family, we like 1 tablespoon of vinegar to 5 of oil. Well, that's entirely up to you. You must remember when you're having a salad dressing, if you're having wine, that if you have too much vinegar, it spoils the taste of the wine. And I think a little jar like this is very convenient to make a dressing in, because you can put all of your ingredients in, shake it all up, and then taste it. So I'm going to start out with some wine vinegar. You can get good wine vinegar in any grocery store now, but be sure it's wine and taste it. It should have a nice taste and not be too strong. And I'm putting in a little bit of dry mustard, about 1/4 teaspoonful, and about 1/4 teaspoon of salt, and some pepper. And I'm putting in some chopped green onion or scallion. Some people don't like that, but we in our family like it very much. I'm putting in 1 tablespoon of that. And then our oil. The nice thing about making it in a little jar like this is that you can shake it all up and then taste it and see how it is and add it. Just shake it. And the mustard makes it all sort of stay together. And now be sure after you've made it, you've tasted it. See, the mustard's made it a little bit thick, which is nice. There's a little bit too much vinegar for my taste. It would be fine for some other people's taste. I'll just put a little more oil in. And if you don't like vinegar, you can use lemon juice or part of each. And I'll put a little bit more salt in. And you shouldn't really make salad dressing ahead. It loses its fresh taste. Because it's so easy to make, you can make it just before we're going to do your salad. So there, that's all ready. And you just pour some in. I think 2/3 of that's going to be enough. And then toss it. And this you do just before you're going to serve your salad. Your dressing is freshly made and your lettuce is all nice and dry. And then you just toss it up just before you're serving it. And then if you'd like, you can sprinkle some fresh green herbs. This is a mixture of parsley and chives. And then if you have your own herb garden, you could have some fresh tarragon or basil or whatever else you like. And now, if you happen to like garlic, you can do this. Here's a piece of stale French bread, and here's a piece of garlic. And I've left one end unpeeled, and you just take the garlic and rub it over the French bread. This is called a chapon. Then you toss it in your salad. Then you can take the chapon out if you like, or you can leave it in. It's awfully good, all coated with garlic and French dressing. And then here's another thing that you can also do. And here's something, this is called a salad mimosa, which seems to have been quite a bit in the news lately. It always sounds like some fancy kind of salad, but all it is a hard-boiled egg yolk, which is pushed through a sieve, like that, with a wooden spoon. And then you put some minced herbs in. I'm just going to put in this mixture of parsley and chives. And the reason it's called mimosa, because a mimosa flower is a little yellow dot on a green bud. So I think I'll take out this lovely chapon. And then you just sprinkle your mimosa over the salad like that. I don't know why that's supposed to be so fancy, because it's so easy to do. But it is very pretty. You see, you've got that yellow and green. There. And now we're going to make mayonnaise. And we're going to do it handmade. This is mayonnaise is something that seems to frighten a lot of people. And I think it frightens them mostly because they don't understand how egg yolks work. And that's the reason I want to do it today, handmade, because once you understand how the egg yolks act, I don't think you'll ever have trouble making mayonnaise. And if you make it by hand, you can also use an electric mixer because it's exactly the same. Now, mayonnaise, as the French understand it, is egg yolks into which oil and vinegar and lemon juice and salt and pepper have been beaten. And the egg yolks accept the oil and hold it in suspension so it looks creamy, in other words, like mayonnaise. And I'm going to use 3 egg yolks here. And I've put a wet pot holder down here because that keeps the bowl from slipping. And if you have a lightweight bowl, you can set the bowl in a heavy pot, and that'll keep it from slipping. And now, egg yolks will accept and digest oil if you, under 3 conditions, which are perfectly simple. First, before you start adding the oil, you beat the egg yolks until they're thick and sticky. And then second, when you start adding the oil, you add it first just drop by drop by drop. It takes a little while for the egg yolks to decide they're going to accept the oil. But if it's added to them very slowly, they will accept it. And as soon as they start thickening, after about half a cup of oil has gone in, then you don't have any more trouble. And the third consideration is that the egg yolks will only take a certain amount, and that is not more than 3/4 cup of oil per yolk. So if you remember those 3 considerations, you won't have any trouble. Beat the egg yolks first, add the oil drop by drop at first, and then don't exceed your proportions of 3/4 cup of oil. I usually add about 1/2 because I like a rather sticky, yolky mayonnaise. Now we'll start. Now first thing is to get your vinegar and your oil and everything all lined up so you don't have to reach for it. And you're going to have a little bit of mustard, and I've got the salt there. Now, you're beating the yolks until they get sticky. That's about a minute. You can do this just as well in an electric mixer if you want, but I think to understand egg yolks, it's best to do it by hand because then you see how it's done. You see, I'm not beating very fast. And if you do this in the wintertime when it's cold, you can even warm the bowl in hot water, and that'll make them get sticky first. And I don't know why it is beating them to get them sticky makes any difference, but you see, now they're sort of creamy. So that's just about right, and you can even do it a little bit more. And then after they've gotten creamy and sticky, you can either add some lemon juice or a little bit of lemon juice and vinegar, about 1/2 tablespoonful. And then some salt. I keep losing these things. I'm putting in about 1/4 teaspoon of salt. And then beat it up again a little bit. And then as to the oil, you can either add all olive oil or a mixture of olive oil and salad oil or all salad oil. Just depends on what you want. I'm going to use 1/2 and 1/2. I'm going to put in a little salad oil first. Now, the thing is with adding your oil, keep your eye on the bottle because at first it just has to go drop by drop. If you keep looking at what you're beating, then you won't see what's happening to your oil. Now, the eye on bottle, and just let a drop go in like that. If you haven't got it, you see, if you rest the oil on the bowl, you can't add too much in. See, there goes a little dollop. This is the only really careful part that you have. Then every once in a while you stop pouring your droplets and look at what you're beating. The main thing is to get the yolks and the oil thoroughly mixed. See, it hasn't thickened yet. If I'd put a little bit less vinegar in it first, it would be much thicker by now. You see, I'm not beating very fast. It doesn't make any difference in which direction you beat either. I don't know, there used to be some old wives' tales about that you had to beat always going around in a circular motion. See, now that still hasn't thickened. You see, I'm keeping my eye on the oil all the time. Now that's thickening a little bit more. You see, with using an electric mixer, you just do exactly the same thing. You just be holding your oil over the bowl, and as soon as it started thickening, you have it. You can also make mayonnaise in an electric blender. In that case, you have to use a whole egg. And if you've gotten an electric blender, they all have the recipe in it. But if you use egg yolks like this, it becomes so thick the blender won't work. So that's why you have to use a whole egg. Now that's thickening up a little bit. When you use the blender, you put the whole egg in, and then you beat in it at high speed. You beat in a tablespoon of lemon juice and of water, and then some dry mustard. And then you turn the blender on high and avert your face so it's not going to hit you in the face unless you have a splash proof on it. Now that's thickening up fairly nicely. I'm going to now add some olive oil in here. If I'd added a little bit less vinegar, I didn't really keep my eye on the bottle, and that would have been thicker than it is now. There. There, now, see? That's a thick cream, and we can still go on adding a little olive oil until it gets thicker. And then if you start out with the correct amount, which is a smaller amount of vinegar in the beginning, by about this time, it'll be so thick that you can't beat it at all, so in that case, you thin it out with a little lemon juice. There. Now, at this point, when it's gotten this thick, you can add your oil a little faster by dollops. And then you taste it. And if you find that it needs more salt and pepper, then you put it in. I love the taste of homemade mayonnaise. That's the trouble, is once you start making it, you always want homemade mayonnaise rather than anything else. So we'll use that later on. And we're now going to do a French potato salad. Now I have here, the French potato salad is always made with hot potatoes. And these are boiled potatoes, which I boiled in their skins and then peeled. I didn't boil them, I steamed them, which is an awfully easy way of doing it. You just put this steamer on top of a pot of boiling water, put in your potatoes, cover it, and then when you stick a knife in and it goes in easily, they're done. And then as soon as you can handle them, you slice them, because you want to season them when it's hot. You slice potatoes just the same way, just down like that with your knife. You want to be sure that you're using boiling potatoes, because if you use baking potatoes, they all come apart. And then you put in a little bit of liquid. This can be chicken stock or white wine or vermouth. And I'm putting in, we've got about 2 cups of potatoes, so I'm putting in about 3 tablespoons of liquid, and then you toss them around, and they absorb some of this liquid, and that means they won't absorb so much oil. And then you let them sit for 3 or 4 minutes, tossing them like that. Then when they've absorbed the liquid, you put on, if you like, some chopped green onions or shallots or scallions, and then a little salt and pepper, and some of your French dressing. I put on about 1/4 cup there, and some minced parsley and chives, and then you toss them again. See, the toss doesn't bruise. It's sort of an up and down motion like that. And there they are. Then you can eat it as hot potato salad, or you can put it in the refrigerator and chill it. It's an awfully good salad. And then, if you want, you can put some mayonnaise on top at the end. And now we're going to make our salad niçoise. Now, salad niçoise is a vegetable salad, and it has potatoes and cooked green beans and tuna and anchovies and tuna and olives and capers and tomatoes in it. And then you can put anything else you want in it. And if you'd like, you can mix it in a bowl, or you can put it on a platter. I rather like to put it on a platter, particularly when I have a nice one like this. This is actually a fish platter, or an asparagus platter. It also has an insert in it, and if you want to use it for fish or asparagus, you have this little insert where extra liquid goes down. And I'm using here Boston lettuce leaves. Just arrange them around nicely. And we have our potato salad, which goes right along there. And then these are green beans. Remember when we did our vegetables, we did beans. You just take the whole bean, pull the end of it off, and then wash it, and then dump it in an enormous kettle of rapidly boiling salted water and boil it until, when you taste it, it's just tender through. And then you rinse it rapidly in cold water and let it dry, and it just lovely. It retains all of its green. And we have our tomatoes, which are just quartered tomatoes. And I have some more salad dressing here. And with one of these salads, you always want to arrange each thing in a bowl and season it first. And this is particularly if you're going to arrange a salad in a bowl, because if you have the large bowl and you put all these a beautiful decoration around and then have to mix it all up, afterwards you've lost the point of it. But if you mix them in separate little bowls first, then you can keep your beautiful artistic arrangement. And if you're a really artistic type, one of these vegetable salads are great fun. You've got your red and your green, so you should think about your color scheme so that you don't say have green against green. There are the tomatoes, and then I have hard-boiled eggs and olives. I'll have to think which would be the nicest way to arrange things. I think if I put the hard-boiled eggs around at the end there, and then the beans. Oh, not even with my spoon. There it is. The beans can go in little bunches like here. But we're serving 4 people so that they can go in the 4 corners like that. There. Now we have our chunks of tuna fish. Nice is in the Mediterranean, so they always have lots of tuna and anchovies and black olives. There's the tuna at each side. And then we have our black olives, which I think can go along here as a little accent. that up. You really have to, with any of these things, you have to use your hands if you're going to have the right kind of an arrangement. And here's some capers. These are Spanish capers, which are much bigger than the ordinary ones and very nice. And then we also have some anchovies, which can fit right over the eggs. There. And now you don't always have to have mayonnaise. In fact, isn't particularly traditional, but as long as we have it, I'm going to put some at the two ends of the lettuce here. There. Oh, I dribbled a little bit on that. Now we have some green herbs, so that can be sprinkled over all. You can put in green peppers and all kinds of other things that you would like. But as long as you have the tuna and the anchovies and the olives, tomatoes, beans and potatoes and lettuce, you have the true salad niçoise. Now this you can use as the first course for a dinner, or you can use it as the main course for a summer luncheon. If it was a main course for a summer luncheon, you could follow your salad niçoise with cheese and fruit. And here we're serving a rosé wine, which is very typical of the region. There. Now, again, to review a bit, but remember to have your lettuce thoroughly washed and well dried, or your dressing won't stick onto the lettuce. And in the French dressing, it's any proportions you like, but be sure that you get good oil and good wine vinegar. And in the mayonnaise, remember the proportions. It's 1/2 to 3/4 cup of oil per yolk. And remember that you beat your yolks until they're thick and sticky first. And don't do what I did, add too much vinegar at once, or it will take too long for the mayonnaise to thicken, but as you can see, that thickened perfectly well. Now, next time on the French Chef, we're going to do foie de volaille, or in translation, all about chicken livers in the French way. We're going to sauté them and make a lovely mousse and a pâté, and I think you'll enjoy it very much. Well, that's all for this time on the French Chef. This is Julia Child. Bon appétit.
Julia Child is co-author of the book Mastering the Art of French Cooking. French Chef is made possible by a grant from Safeway Store.